So as I said before with the Esquire, I have mine, you know, three usable tones in a way. Long ago when I got the guitar, I lifted the leg of the bass or that mute capacitor, like a trumpet mute, in the forward position to kind of play those bassy rhythm parts. And I added another cap there to kind of give me a little bit of a P90-ish kind of tone. So that's a usable tone I do have now in forward position with one pickup. In the middle position, you have your volume and tone both working for you. And all the way back, you have your pickup going right through the volume pot, right to the jack. So no tone pot involved on that. So you essentially get three different sounds, and you can preset this volume, which is really cool for the middle section. But yeah, I'll just run through them right now so you can hear the tones. Okay, so my forward position, here it goes. Middle position where the tone is working for you. Basic tools here. I'm just going to dig into it now. Like I said, I'm going to try to do this and keep the strings. It's going to be a little tricky, but I just put this set on and I want to keep as many variables out as I can. I'm not going to touch any amp settings or anything like that. So while the soldering iron is heating up, I'm just basically gonna walk you through what I'm planning on doing here. So I'm just gonna detach the two wires for the pickup. Like I said, I know some people may say, oh, you're crazy for modifying it, but I can always put it back And this guitar inspires me so much that it's not going anywhere. When it comes to pickup height adjustment, because we're dealing with a completely flat pole here and a raised pole on this one, I'm basically going to take a measurement of my pickup height from the top of the bobbin and set this bobbin up the same way. And we'll just see what we have. That way it's an even playing field, and we'll see what each one does. But I'm just letting the iron heat up so I can get a nice hot joint and get this pickup out. I'm not dealing with a ton of solder or a big mess here, but I just tuck a piece of paper under there just to kind of, protect the guitar, protect the finish. Anybody who's ever messed with the old Fender stuff, the old amps, the old stuff just has a smell to it that is, I don't know, it just gets me excited. It's the little things, right? So there we go. Our pickup is unsoldered. Now we're just gonna get this out. It's good to see the body date over there, 457. Okay, so here it is. Here's a 57 Tele pickup. Bet that would go for decent money on eBay. So here's what I'm thinking with this Champ pickup here. Now the Champ pickup will not line up to any of the holes properly, and we know that, and that's okay. But what I'm thinking is, get these grommets off. Also, guys, too, if you have a Telecaster pickup that's microphonic, sometimes just replacing the shrink tubing will help. If it's a little sturdier, it has some more strength, it can really hold the pickup stable. What's up, guys? So a quick little sidebar. My True Vintage Guitar t-shirt just came in, and I figured I'd give you a little heads up of my friend John Schultz. He's the proprietor of True Vintage Guitar. They have a great Instagram, and John just started posting YouTube of videos of his recent acquisitions, his guitars that he's gone on safaris for and brought, and most important and most interestingly, this flawless 1957 Telecaster, which is basically a twin to mine, only it's a Telecaster with a two pickup option. So we're going to hear a little bit about this guitar from John. I urge you guys, if you're vintage guitar nerds, to check out John's Instagram and John's YouTube channel. I'll put the links down below. Thanks, John. Peace.
So believe it or not, this guitar is all factory original, never had anything done to it. Original finish, frets, electronics, wiring. The only thing we did have to adjust the nut slots to accommodate for, 10 gauge non-flat wound strings, because that's what it had when it came in. It had the original 1960s flat wounds on it. Just very little fret wear. It's a truly unbelievable guitar. One of the things I was chatting with Nick about was the original wiring on these Teles. So, the bridge position is just the bridge pickup with the tone control. Middle is just the neck pickup with tone control. And the third position is the neck pickup with a dark cap. So it's not the best sounding wiring setup. If this wasn't a super clean, all original example, I'd probably be swapping it up for a more modern setup. But since it's completely original, there's no way I'd go messing with it. I'm going to plug it into this Silvertone, just play it a little bit for you guys. Thank you so much, Nick. Pick up. dark cap on the neck pickup. Not terribly useful these days, unfortunately. The other thing that me and Nick were talking about was, or actually Nick was showing me, and thank you, Nick. I did not know this, actually, because I haven't had a ton of Telecasters with original wiring pre-1967. But you can find that in-between position if you go in between the bridge and the middle position. So that way you can get both pickups, but they are out of phase, so you get kind of a, you know, a little bit thinner, a little bit quackier tone. So here's the bridge again. Here's the neck. Here's the in-between, out of phase. Back to the bridge. The 1957 Fender Telecaster. I am just about to pack this one up to send it to a new home. Really didn't last but 20 minutes or so, I think, before selling after I bought it back in Texas. But anyway, thank you so much, Nick, for letting me pop in. 1957 Telecaster. You can check out more pictures of this one at truevintageguitar.com if you want to. Thanks, Nick. Check you guys later.
Okay, so right now I'm basically finding where the pickup wants to sit in the bridge, on the cover. All right, guys, so here's where we're at. Like I said, I had to use the bridge itself to kind of work as a template. I got the flat pole pickup in there, and then I, the base plate is steel but copper coated, so it's still magnetic, so it clung to the back side of the pickup, and then I would keep shifting it and adjusting it until the holes of the base plate all lined up. So they're all lined up now. What I'm going to do is drop the screws out, mount the pickup to the base plate for good, and then we're going to put the donuts in there. We'll tighten it all up. We're going to put the surgical tubing in there. We'll get it all tightened up. We'll string it up, and we'll see what kind of sounds we get. It's definitely a tricky process, but it does work. It's pretty straightforward. You just got to have some patience. All right, guys, so we're looking like we're installed. Here's what I did again, just to give you a rundown. I basically removed, I installed the pickup and then put the base plate underneath it. I let the base plate grab onto the pickup because it's magnetic. And then I shifted the base plate until it lined up with the three screw holes here. Then once I had that lined up correctly, I removed the bridge again, put it aside. All the time, the base plate is still magnetized to the pickup, so that's not moving. Then I made some slight marks to be able to line it up again. I put some of this, this Gorilla tape here. Is really, really thin, and it's super strong. So I put that as an insulator between the poles at the bottom and the base plate, and also held the pickup onto the base plate. I then reinstalled the pickup with the surgical tubing as an adjuster. I had to extend the leads just slightly, and now we're ready for install. It was kind of a pain. I found myself getting frustrated with it, but I just took my time. We're going to get it in the guitar now and see what's up. I just want to say I really recommend this one for anybody who just wants to check and make sure their last nerve is still there. because this one was a bit trying on the patience. Make sure your base plate fits in the route. Make sure the pickup doesn't overhang on the base plate too much and hit the route on the way in. And like I said, just take your time and try to be patient. There were a couple times here where so we're just getting it. We're getting it buttoned up now. We're getting the bridge back in though. Pickup is installed. We're gonna wire it up now. This should go fairly easy. But the whole job should have went fairly easy. It did. It went easy for my first time not knowing what to expect, but there's a lot more. Like, if I was doing these for somebody, or if I was going to do more of these, I would have, like, a spare, like, a dummy bridge, and just basically get it all mocked up. That way, it was good to go in somebody else's guitar. Sorry, I know I don't have my piece of paper down protecting the finish, but it's old. Well, we're dealing with a little microphonics. That's understandable. I said I kept the same strings on, so I'm just trying to stretch them enough and get them in tune. Definitely got more breakup. I don't know if you want to call it breakup, gain, attack. In the camera, but there's definitely like more of a compression thing going on. It's squishing it up. added like this little bit of a sweetness to it, to where it's not as harsh on the ears to me, the flat pole. Of the flat pole pickup, it was cool. It had its moments. I only played it for this video, but my ears were already telling me I favor the raised pole piece of the 57 pickup. The guitar itself, it made the forward position that had that extra capacitor. It kind of made it a little warmer, a little more like tone rolled on. The middle position was actually very usable and very bright, and back, all the way back, was just a nice pick, which is very indicative of, you know, the Blackguard era Telecasters. It didn't sound bad. It has a great sound. It definitely added a little more compression and a little more gain using the Deluxe, which is really, really nice. I don't have a bad thing to say about it, but I mean, I'll put the original pickup back in next time I put the strings on. It definitely tried my patience, and I'm glad that I didn't throw the guitar or the pickup or any of the tools or the phone across the room. I did really well in that aspect. But yeah, I mean, if you had it at your service or you needed a pickup for a restore project, or I don't know, I wouldn't go crazy ears like the other one, the original one, but your style and your taste may be different, you know? I just know on this one, I'm going to put the original one back in. But yeah, at least we tried. You know, there we go. We're set up. We got that flat pole pickup in there. And, you know, we had fun with it. It was a project. It was, we got, you know, it was cool to bring you guys along for the videos. And, you know, we got to be tone geeks and try some things out. In this video, you can use it if you want to build a pickup yourself. I mean, my techniques may be different from others you're seeing or you've seen online, and that's fine. It's just how my brain told me to do it. Super, super cool. A lot of fun, though. And, you know, I was trying to get this video done, and maybe, you know, maybe in some time I'll leave the pickup in and I'll keep playing it and I'll have some fun with it. And you never know, maybe this flat pole pickup may stay. But for now, I mean, there it is. We got it done. We got the flat pole lap steel pickup into the 57 Esquire, trying to conjure up some of those Blackguard tones. And yeah, man, I hope you guys dig this video. Excuse the playing. I'm always trying to learn. I'm not a Tele master or a Strat master or any guitar master. I'm learning every day. But yeah, I hope you guys can take something from this. I hope you guys have fun with this video. And don't be afraid to tweak on your own guitars, because it's a lot of fun. We'll talk soon. Peace.